Hello, we are the second group, and we decided to make a series story map, to choose this one, because we think it's we could better categorize what we have done. So, first of all, we have an introduction of the area of Santorini. Santorini is the southernmost volcanic center in the Hellenic volcanic arc. We are in an area of the subduction zone of the African plate beneath the Eurasian. And so we can see the volcanic arc from Methanot, Milos, Santorini, Nisiros, Kos. Santorini consists of three volcanic centers in northeast-southwest direction from Christiana, Nean Palaeokameni, and Colombo. These centers have erupted the last 2 million years. The second tab has to do with the basement of Santorini. We can see that at Prophetes Lias, we couldn't see, but we had the metamorphic rocks beneath the Mesozoic limestones, and the first here, which was 100 thickness. Also, we can see the base map at Athenios Port, this is the image of Athenios Port. We have the contact between the metamorphic basement and the Minoan eruption. And also here we had a serious problem of geohazards, because if something happens, it's very dangerous and very difficult for all people to exit the island.
Then we are talking about the island formation, that we talked first about the dikes we found, then about the red beach, and finally the red rock beach we saw 2 days ago. And then we make also a section talking about the geohazards and the risks, and finally survey and risk management. First of all, we have there's 91 dikes mapped already with the northeast to southwest direction, and we have seen it near to Ia yesterday, and also in the Thynaxia Island. Most of them has been arrested. They didn't arrive to the surface, and then the red beach, we stopped in the red beach also. We saw the red materials, characteristic red materials then, and the age of these materials is around 750 kilo years. These rocks is the product of a pyroclastic activity. And we also saw these materials in the Red Rock Beach. And they conform the oldest volcanic rocks of the Iceland. And we see the scoria lavas just above the old volcanic basement. And we found the pitch, the P2 phase, that is about 10 centimeters, P3 that is about 6 meters. And we talk about the geohazards about these two places, because they have a the layers have a high inclination, these older volcanic rocks, and the Minoan deposits. They have they produce a high amount of landslides. These two layers, P23, and yeah, it can be a risk for the environment. The vulnerability is super high because people can access to these places. So finally, we talk about the survey and the risk management. And we were thinking about the netting to put nets around these zones, but it's not the best solution. So we thought that maybe to stop the access to these zones is the best solution.
So after the lavas and scoria came the Minoan eruption of the late Bronze Age, and this formed a lot of what you see on the island today, a lot of pumices, pyroclastic flow material. So the eruption events has composed of five main phases. And first we visited, went to Ferris Beach first, but then Metaxa Mine. And here you can really clearly see phase 0, 1, 2, a tiny bit of 3 in tiny space, and phase 4. So I'm just going to talk you through the phases quite quickly. So, first you have below the phases, we had a paleosaur, which in some places you could see, fossilized olive trees and palm trees. And then above this, a very thin layer, which is about 10 centimeters of phase 0, which you can't see from these pictures because it was very, very small. But that was just a sort of precursory explosions. And it had some accretions and trees in it. And then phase one was a lot thicker, was around sort of, I think, 2-3 meters in this place. And this was much coarser pumice material, which had a fairly, it was fairly great in some places. You had sort of some lenses of like coarser and finer pumice. And this represents an eruption which had a massive ash plume of between like 36 and 41 kilometers high. And then phase two represents pyroclastic flow deposits. You can see this in the very thin, thinly grained, very well bedded material. You have surge deposits, there was some cross lamination in some places, and there was also, I think, some accretion in the building as well. So, a little bit of wet accretion in the beginning. During this phase, the sort of the cone of the caldera was filled up with pumice, and there was also it was a wet eruption, so you had some debris flows that were represented by the massive large deposits. And we found in one tiny place there was actually really good evidence of a debris flow, which we've got a picture here. which had some secondary sort of metamorphic rocks in it, which have been pushed down into the top of phase three. And then phase four, which was the most destructive phase, this was pyroclastic flows and some lava deposits. And I can't pronounce it, but it's the ignimbrites, which and these pyroclastic flows were around 450 degrees Celsius, so very, very hot, very destructive, and it was a dry explosion here. So the catara was not the problem. We saw the same deposits in Ferros Beach, although none of phase three at all. A little bit of a different thickness. And then we also saw some at Red Rock Beach. We saw phase three, very clear representation of phase three. And phase two as well. And then we have some risks, obviously, with sort of landslides again. So on quite a lot of landslide risks. And also it's quite important to understand the sort of characteristics of this eruption. So survey risk management, everyone's there, but we all see that the ROV, the drone, and we did the flight drone, just to sort of conduct, create an onshore, nearshore, offshore representation. And yeah, that's, it's just better to sort of understand the geohazard so we can be mitigated a little bit better.
So we're coming to the Yakomeni, and as you probably noticed that we're going to a time sequence here, so our story map is built up as a time sequence of the island formation. And Yakomeni is therefore the youngest part of the volcanic area. And it's so the island, or the Kameni Islands, are Nea Kameni, which is the bigger one, and Palea Kameni. And on Nea Kameni are four different volcanic craters, which had several eruptions throughout, which started in 1570, the first eruption. And there were supposed to be polygons here. They disappeared. And just to show that the red line here is the way we walked, and the blue circles is where we took temperatures. And we could see that the temperature increased the higher we went up to the vent, and the vent on top here was the George crater, which was formed in 1866. And yeah, so Nea Kameni had, as I said, several eruptions. And so the first one was this little bit here in 1570. And then here around,